very warm good evening here in Kampala, where we are broadcasting from at our head offices, and to be specific, an industrial area. This is The News Again with me, Dennis Wonyala.
And I'm Lydia Lacuaniero. Welcome to The News.
We now head over straight to our first story, where the row between the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, and her deputy, Jacob Olanya, is far from over. This was evidently shown yesterday as MPs consoled Kadaga over the death of her niece, with Koboko woman MP Margaret Babadiri questioning the whereabouts of the deputy speaker. Now, the speaker brushed it off. Today, after over a year of not chairing any sitting in parliament, the deputy speaker declined, claiming that he is also mourning with his colleague. Take a look.
On Tuesday, the Speaker of Parliament informed the House that Wednesday's sitting would be chaired by her deputy, Jacob Olanya, since she had lost her niece. Kadaga had earlier brushed off the concern by members of parliament inquiring where her deputy was operating from, saying they will not fail to see him when he's around.
We shall be having a brief sitting today. We have suffered a tragedy in our home. Madam Speaker, you have a deputy speaker who should help you when you are busy, when you're in a problem. I'd like to find out what has happened to the deputy speaker.
It's public secret that Olanya and Kadaga will face off again for the speaker's job in May, 5 years after a bitter battle for the top job that ended with an intervention by President Museveni. Recently, MPs supported a proposal in the Constitution Amendment Bill 2019 to introduce a speaker's panel of more than four, citing the heavy workload. After a year of not stepping foot in the chambers of parliament, all members were ready for the sitting this afternoon. Clad in his speaker's attire with his entrance led by the sergeant arms, at 2 o'clock, Deputy Speaker Jacob Olanya made his way to parliament's tent after a year to chair today's sitting. As usual, Olanya first sent happy new year regards to his colleagues, since he had not had a chance to talk to them since last year.
Let me start by wishing you all a very happy new year. I did not have the opportunity to do that. I'd almost forgotten how this place looks like. But somehow it looks the same, except that there's too much light. I can almost not see the faces of the honorable members. But I guess that is because of the new situation that we have to deal with.
Though he had received the information to chair today's parliament at 4 p.m. yesterday, he agreed to this, even though it's an emotional time when the speaker lost her niece, who, according to the deputy, is like her daughter.
When the reasons for my coming to chair was stated to me, I felt like I was between a hard place and a rock, because this here is an emotionally difficult situation. And it's in that situation that I am being asked to step in. It's one of those very difficult situations to balance.
It was at this juncture that informed Parliament that they cannot go on with the sitting with one of their own mourning.
That the Madam Speaker has lost a dear one, and the battle is ongoing. I can only do what I have always done in situations like this. Will not be able to proceed with today's sitting in solidarity with the speaker.
Olanya said that even if it was his last chance to chair their 10th parliament, he would not proceed as the speaker mourns.
Even if it was the last chance, the last opportunity given to me to preside in the 10th parliament, if this was the last opportunity, it's an opportunity I'm willing to let go, because it's not human for me to proceed with this business.
Olanya has not chaired any parliamentary session for over a year now, raising concerns from some legislators.
I also want to thank the angel, the God-sent angel, Honorable Margaret Babadiri, who raised a very important question yesterday about where you've been.
And although I didn't make it, I know we shall be around to see you helping spearheading the legislation in this country.
He last chaired the House on 4th February 2020. Story compiled by Rachel Nakasi and Obed Lutale for the news in Kampala.